As a result of studying this section, you will learn the working principles of the standard model of the rotary vane actuator, the working principles of the IMO model of the rotary vane actuator, how the IMO system reacts to a leakage, the working principles of the RAM type actuator. Basically, there are two types of electro-hydraulic steering gear working principles, the RAM type and the rotary vane type. The working principles of the two are very similar. A strong, slow movement of a mechanical surface is created by the use of high oil pressure. RAM type uses cylinder pistons. Rotary vane uses pressure working on the side of a vane. On the RAM type, the piston is connected by a ram to a tiller, and the tiller is fixed to the rudder stock, creating the rotating movement. On the rotary vane, the vane is fixed to a boss that is fixed directly to the stock. The principles, as described for the rotary vane steering gear, can easily be transformed to the RAM type. Typical for RAM type steering gears is that they work with a much higher hydraulic pressure. They need an external rudder stock bearing, and the working angle is limited compared with the rotary vane steering gear. The standard model is used on all vessels except tankers with single rudder installation above 100,000 deadweight tons. Safety. Safety against single failure on the hydraulic system according to SOLAS rules. The IMO model is specially designed for tankers with single rudder installation above 100,000 deadweight tons to comply with the SOLAS rules. It can also be used for other ships and or rudder arrangements where extraordinary safety is wanted. Safety. Safety against single failure on the hydraulic system according to SOLAS rules. This is a schematic drawing of the standard steering gear. You can click on the buttons marked port or starboard to see how it works, and click on the different parts for more information. The model shows a normal operation situation with one pump running. Using both pumps will double the speed of the rudder. This is a schematic drawing of the IMO steering gear. You can click on the buttons marked port or starboard to see how it works, and click on the different parts for more information. The model shows a normal operation situation with one pump running. Using both pumps will double the speed of the rudder. You will now be shown how the IMO system reacts on a leakage. To view how this situation is displayed on the wheelhouse panel, click the link. The IMO steering gear is redundant for leakage over the vane seals. So, if the oil can bypass one of the vanes for any accidental reason, the leaking vane can be put out of function, and the steering gear will operate on the other vane only. However, if a leakage should occur over one of the stoppers, both vanes will be inoperable. A situation like this is not covered by the SOLAS class requirements. The double IMO will protect against accidental bypass over one of the stoppers as well. The double IMO is designed for ship owners who want the most ultimate safety, further than required by the SOLAS or class rules. The purpose of the locking device is to fix the rudder in any position and may be used during maintenance of steering gear, anchoring, or towing.